Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to take up the first lesson of your supplementary reader Vistas, named The Third Level by Jack Finney. Jack Finney was an American writer who wrote science fictions and thrillers. Some of his books have been filmed, and the most important was The Body Snatchers. This third level is also a science fiction where you can say he travels into time, right? This story is about a man, a common man, whose name is Charlie, 31 years old, very normal, working in an office. And he tries to travel in time. He wants to go back. Okay. Now you must know something about Grand Central Station. Grand Central Station in America is a subway. There are two levels. Okay. The first level, where there are faster trains which go to cities and towns, and the second level is the trains which take you to the suburban areas, right? So there are two levels in Grand Central Station. It's a very important subway in America, and related to this is the third level. Okay, so two levels of subways. Subway is the metros that run, the fast trains that take less time, the metros, the underground trains, that is the subway. So two levels are there, and here the author Charlie, who is 31 years old, very normal, very hard-working man in the office, he says that he had been to the third level, and this he tells to his psychiatrist. The psychiatrist is his friend, and he says that he had been to the third level at Grand Central Station. The psychiatrist says that there are only two levels at Grand Central Stations. Okay, Grand Central Station has only two level. This is like waking dream. That means you are awake and you are dreaming. There can't be a third level. The reasons that he gave, that Charlie supposed that he had been to the third level, was that he was very unhappy. Unhappy because of his life, because of his style of living, because of the surrounding, because of the modern world, which is full of insecurity, fear, war and worries and whatnot, right? So all these had made him unhappy, and that is why he wanted to escape. He wanted to go to a place where he could find peace, right? And that is why he had found the third level. All his friends agree to it, and they say that he has a hobby of stamp collection, which is also a temporary refuge. That means that is also a way of escaping. So he wants to escape, and that is why he has been, or he thinks that he had been to the third level, right? He says that the stamp collection had started with his grandfather, and he had inherited all his grandfather's stamps, the collection of stamps, and his grandfather did not want to run away from the life, because his life was very peaceful. He was enjoying his life to the fullest, right? So he says that this is not the fact. He does not accept it. Okay, his father had a lot of stamps which his grandfather had, all the US issues, on certain events the stamps are issued, that is called the US issue, or the first day covers. First day covers are the envelopes in which the stamp which is published on that particular day is purchased by the people, and they paste the stamp and they write their own address on it. They put a blank paper in it. There is no letter in the envelope. The blank paper along with the first stamp that is released on that day, and it is posted. Either it is self-addressed or it is addressed to your friends or relatives whom you want to give, right? And when the postage stamp is put there, there is the post office's mark with the date which verifies that yes, particularly on this day the stamp had been published. So it is called the first day covers. Cover is envelope. Okay, so his father, grandfather had all this collection of stamps, a beautiful collection. You know what is a person who collects the stamp is called, right? He is called a philatelist. This story started a year ago in summer, when Charlie was returning from his office and he was in a hurry to reach his home, reach to his wife Lucia. He wanted to take the subway, which was faster than the bus. So he wanted to take the subway. So he went to Grand Central Station, right? Now he was going there and he met other people just dressed like him in garbage and suits and straw hats, banded hats. So he was not trying to escape, right? He was going regularly on Grand Central Station. So this was also one of those regular days. So he went to first level, from where the faster city trains went. Then he went to second level, but in between he dug into an odd doorway and he lost his way. When he lost his way, he thought that he was right. He did not think that he had lost his way, because here he says that the Grand Central Station has grown like a big tree, right? The roots of the tree, which are going in all directions. Sometimes he says that when he goes to the levels tunnel and he reaches three stations away, so he gets lost. So it was very simple for him. This time also, when he reached the place, he thought that he was right. When he was going, he did not meet anyone, okay, and he did not hear anyone. So he thought that something was wrong, but when he heard something, some noises, some people talking, he thought that it was okay. He was on the right path. So he reached there, right, from the corner which angled to the left and then slanting to the downwards, and he kept on walking, and when he reached there, he thought that it was the third level. How did he find out? It was not the normal first level or the second level, right? It was the ticket counters were fewer, right? And the train gates, they were also less in number. And the information booth at the center, it was wooden and it was old looking, right? It was not modern looking, it was old looking. There was a man on the booth. He was wearing green eye shades, that is the glasses, and he was wearing long black sleeve protectors are the covers that you wear from your wrist to your elbow, right? From your wrist to your elbow, so that your sleeves, full sleeves shirts are protected. They don't get dirty while you are working on the disc. So on both the wrists to the elbow, the protectors are worn to protect your clothes from getting dirty. So he was wearing that. He saw that the light was very, very dim. And then he turned around to see, and it was open flame gas light. Right? It was the gas light which was open. Right? So it was very dim, flickering. And on the platform, there were many brass spittoons. You know, spittoons where one spits. Yeah, there are spittoons, and there was a man. He saw something shining. And then when he looked at the man, he took out a gold watch from his vest pocket, and he was looking at the time, grumbling. He was wearing a derby hat. Derby hat is the round top flat hot hat. He was wearing the four button suit with tiny lapels, which was very, very old fashioned, and he was having a handlebar mustache. That was big mustache, just like in 1890s, right? There were people around, few people, but they were around, and they were having the beards, different kinds of beards and sideburns. Sideburns are the hair growth that you have below your hair near the ears, right? That is the sideburns. And all of them were having fancy mustache. It was something like the 1890s. Now this is the story of around 1940s, right? So it was way back. So he says that something is wrong. Then there was a stack of newspapers kept there. So he looked at the newspaper. The name of the newspaper was The World. And that newspaper had stopped being published long ago. So this was the newspaper which was not in circulation at present. Then something about President Cleveland was printed there, and the date that was there was June 11, 1894. Now this was very surprising for him, and he was very, very happy. Right? He wanted to go to Galesburg, Illinois in 1894. The author himself graduated from Illinois, Galesburg, Illinois, right? So Jack Finney graduated from Illinois, so he had this background of Illinois, which seemed to him very, very tempting, right? So here he mentions about Illinois, and here Charlie wanted to go to Illinois because he thought that his grandfather lived in Illinois, Galesburg, and it was the most a tempting place, a most enjoyable place where he could go. So he wanted to go to Illinois in a time in 1894 where the First World War was some 20 years off, and Second World War was over 40 years in future. So he was very, very happy that it is a very nice time that he could go back in time. So he went to buy the tickets. When he went to buy the tickets, he asked for the amount. And when he wanted to pay the money, he took out the cash from his pocket and kept it on the counter. The man at the counter looked at him surprisingly, because that money was not in circulation. Right? He looked into the cash counter and he saw those old styled notes there. He took the money and ran away from there, thinking that the person in the counter, cash counter, would call the police. And living in prison in any time is not good at all. So he thought that he would be in prison, so he ran away from there. Right? Now next day he took the $300 that he had in his account, the total money, and then he bought the old currency because he wanted to find the third level. He was not able to find. Right? His wife was worried that what her husband is doing. right? She was worried about Charlie, and both of them went to the psychiatrist. Now, after some time, he stopped searching. Okay, he stopped searching for the third level, but resorted back to his stamp collection. And then one day, both husband and wife, that is Charlie and Lucia, both started searching for third level. His wife was also accompanying him in searching the third level. This had happened because while going through the stamps, he found one of the envelopes, right? That the first day covers. He thought that this first day cover was not in his stock. It was not in his collection. But it was addressed to his grandfather. He opened it, right? And he found a letter inside. Usually, I've told you that in the first day covers, there is no letter at all. Either there is a blank paper or the envelope is empty, right? But there was a letter. This letter was addressed to Charlie. Although on the cover, the address of his grandfather was there. And there was a letter. A letter which said, "Charlie, first I thought, I wished whatever you were saying was right. Then I believed what you said was right." Right? He said, "First I wished you were right, and then I believed that you were right, and it's true. I have found the third level." Right? He said that he is enjoying. This letter was from a friend of Charlie called Sam. Okay? Sam was writing the letter and he said that he is enjoying his stay in 1894. And he said that someone is playing the piano and people are singing, say, "Seeing Nellie Home." And he has been invited on a lemonade and he is enjoying. He said, "Keep looking for the third level." Okay? He said, "Keep looking for the third level." Now, this letter was from Sam. Now, who was Sam? Sam was Charlie's psychiatrist. Okay? Now, Sam had disappeared. He was in Illinois. Okay? And he was very happy with his hay, feed and grain business there, because he could not do his job there. He was the psychiatrist. And 1894, you don't need psychiatrist, right? There was peace all around. There was no need of a psychiatrist in the society. So he was happy with his hay, feed and grain business. When Charlie tried to find out, he found that Sam had taken the money which he had, the $800, and those he had changed into old currency, and he had disappeared, right? He had disappeared in the past. Now Charlie and Lucia both were searching for the third level, right? You can say this story is an illusion. Charlie wished to be transported, right, to the third level, where he would be taken to the world of 1894, which is supposed to be much happier and quieter place to be. Now the question is whether the third level existed or not, whether the third level was in the mind of Charlie or was it a real third level. See, we can say that third level did not exist, but the Sam's letter, it was a proof that third level did exist, right? So we can say that it is a story of escapism, right? It might be a thought of Charlie who wants to just run away from the complexities of the life, the hustle and bustle, the running of the people in the life. He wanted to be at peace, and that is why he was searching peace in the form of third level, which could take him to 1894, where people used to sit in the evening, where there were trees all around giving a shade on the roads, where the ladies used to sit outside, right, using that fan made up of palm leaves, where there were fireflies all around. That means people were spending a leisure life, right? So he wanted to lead a leisure life, and this is somewhat a story on science fiction combined with escapism, right? Where a person wants to get away from the running of the life, the fear and the anxiety and all those pressure on the person, and wanted to lead a peaceful life.